Well, now for our regular catch-up with our ITV Fixers. There's young people aged between 16 and 25 who live in the Midlands and are doing some pretty amazing things to benefit others.
Tonight, we meet a group of Coventry teenagers who've all been affected by knife crime. Tired of living in fear, they're now launching a campaign to urge carriers to drop knives to save lives.
Research has shown that children at the age of 11 have carried a knife.
The majority of offenders are aged between 16 and 29.
Possession of a knife in a public place could lead up to 4 years imprisonment.
Unfortunately, what they don't realise is that if they carry a knife, they're more likely to become a victim.
Knife crime can happen at any time of the day.
My name's Stacey Smythe, I'm 17 years old. I'm one of a group of teenagers from Coventry who've become fixers to launch a campaign to stop young people carrying knives and using them.
Everyone in my group feels passionate about doing knife crime because we've all been affected in it some way, whether it's been through family or friends.
We want everyone, or at least most people, to drop their knives and save lives.
We all got together by joining a 10-week course called Our Place, and we made a brilliant video. We had nowhere to put it, so that's where ITV Fixers come into it to help us get it across.
For young people growing up in Coventry, it's kind of sad because young people have to get used to the fact that knife crime's happening. It's part of their daily life. They can't go certain places at certain times because it's just so fearful. Members of my family have been mugged with a knife, and one of my friends have actually been stabbed before in the leg.
I carried a knife purely for protection because it's either you or them, and once it's gone too far you can't stop it. It takes two people to stop it, and if you stop and they don't, then you're losing either way.
Today ITV Fixers have arranged for us to show our presentation for the first time.
What did you think of the film?
Give us like all the facts and all the consequences of what knife crime can have, and like hopefully it could deter us from carrying a knife and potentially warn us of the risks of people who do carry knives and what impact it has not on only their victims' lives but also their lives as well.
Has anyone here ever been affected by knife crime yourself?
When I was younger, when I was at school, I was getting bullied by a bunch of girls on the way home from school one night, and I had a knife pulled to my throat.
How did it affect you in the long run?
I wouldn't go out my front door for at least a good couple of months. It's made me think twice about going out in the streets and stuff. Like, with headphones, I only wear one now, so I can hear who's coming behind me.
What sort of age group is it that you know of people that do carry knives?
17 onwards, I know, that carry knives, and sometimes I see friends that regret it, but they just carry it around to be safe or something like that.
I think that it's ideal that young people are the ones that are delivering the message. It's all very well me going into a school or me talking to a group of young people here. These young people have been either indirectly or directly affected by knife crime, and therefore they're the ones really that should be given the message, so it's great that they're committed to doing so.
If you don't drop your knives, then you'll either be sent to jail or you will be stabbed. It's as simple as that.
OK, guys, and go.
At the end of this project, we hope that it changes attitudes of young people that actually do carry knives and think that it's cool to do it. So if they do and they drop their knives, they'll be saving lives and making the streets a much safer place.
Great idea. And if you want further information, visit itvfixers.com or you can call 0121 270 5070.
Now, that's a non-premium rate call, and your network operator rates will apply from a BT landline. Calls from other networks may be higher, and from mobiles, they'll be considerably more.
Yes, please do seek the bill payer's permission before phoning. Lines close on the 31st of December 2010 at 5 p.m. Calls made after the closing time will not be answered, but may still be charged.